And it's sounding like, you know, Donald Trump got into office beyond Allah's will. As if Allah did not will it and Donald Trump like challenged Allah. Wallahi, this is how it's sounding. Wal'ayadu billah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, Qulillahumma malika al-mulk. Allah is the owner of al-mulk, of the kingship. Tu'ti al-mulka man tasha. Allah willed for him to become the president. Tu'ti al-mulka man tasha. وَتَنْزِعُ الْمُلْكَ مِمَّنْ تَشَاءُ. And you take the kingship from whomever you will. وَتُعِزُّ مَنْ تَشَاءُ. And يعني you honor, dignify whom you will. وَتُذِلُّ, you humiliate, put down whom he wills. مَنْ تَشَاءُ. Look at this at the end. What? بِيَدِكَ الْخَيْرُ. All of this is خير. The fact that he given the kingship to this one and took it away from this one, dignified this one, humiliated this one, it's all what? Khair.
People like Donald Trump, they prove the Quran right. Allah says in Surah Furqan, chapter number 25, that there will be an enemy for Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. And since Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, his message is going to be till eternity, they are bound to be critics and enemies of Islam and of Prophet Muhammad. So these people are proving the Quran right, because in spite of all these things, Islam is spreading. Allah says in the Quran, in Surah Imran chapter 3 verse 54, Allah says, مَقْرُوا مَقْرَ اللَّهُ وَاللَّهُ خَيْرُ الْمَاقْرِينَ. They plan and plotted, Allah too plan. Allah is the best of planner. If you see after 9/11, the media war on Islam and throughout the world, normally people should think that now Islam should perish, na'uzubillah. Yeah. They cannot. But we find that more people want to know what kind of religion is this. And we find that in USA alone, in a span of about 9 months, after 9/11, 34,000 Americans accepted Islam. In Europe alone, in a span of 10 months after 9/11, more than 20,000 Europeans accepted Islam. So more they are trying to attack Islam, more Islam is spreading. I believe that in the long run, it is benefit for Islam. People want to know what is this religion. Yeah. And whenever people attack Islam, you find that in the long run, it benefits Islam.
And I told you this story before, and I have to tell it to you just to restore that belief in al-Qadr. You know that king who had a minister? A king and a minister. The minister is the type who believes in al-Qadr. Qada illahi wa qadari. For one day, the king is messing around with a knife. He cut his finger. For the minister said, khayr insha'Allah. This is good insha'Allah. Rajul belief, ya'alima. For the king got upset and he said, what good in me cutting my finger? Take him to jail. Put him in jail. Arrest him. So they arrested him. He was placed in jail. So in his way to jail, he said, what? Khair insha'Allah. It's good insha'Allah. There is goodness in this one too, insha'Allah. It was the habit of the king and minister that every week they go out to hunt and have a nomad kind of lifestyle. Of course, he doesn't have his minister. The minister used to be the one who leads his way. He doesn't have him this time. He got lost in the jungle. He got arrested by a group of Bedouin who used to worship idols. And it happens that this day they are supposed to offer a qurbani, a human qurbani to their idol. He said, we will not find anyone better than this guy. He's dressed so nice. I mean, he's the qurbani right here. But they looked at his hand, they found him missing a finger. They said, we offer a qurbani like this to our God. Get out of here. You're not even good to be a qurbani. So he was spared. In his way back to the palace, he started reflecting upon the statement, saying, now I understand Why the minister said it's good that I lost my finger? Because would I have that finger, I would have been slaughtered by now. So immediately when he arrived at his palace, he requested the release of the minister. He said, listen, I understood why you said khair, but what is good in you going to jail? He said, would I have been with you on that journey, I would have been the qurbani. So it's all good. This is the style of iman. This is, ya ikhwa, the asset of faith. This is what faith provides for a believer that no one else can give.